Hey, so I've been using Raycast for a little while now on the Mac, and I'm going to be showcasing why Raycast is such a powerful app to use. There are many features that Raycast provides, but there is one specific thing, which is the window management. As you can see right here, this thing is very powerful. I could go and maximize it. I could go and push it to the left side of my window. All you have to do is Command Space instead of Spotlight or Alfred. And then just choose the command you want and press enter on it, and it will switch the sides for you. The better way is to put a keybind on it, which I actually did, and you'll see in the video where I'm actually switching windows here and forth using that keybind. But let's talk about how Raycast also has an app switcher just like Spotlight and Alfred. But this thing is quite powerful in a way where you'll see in a second here that when I use the touchpad to swipe to the left, you'll notice that there's this slight delay before you can type anything or before that window gets focused. So Raycast fixes that. I mean, you could set the control key in your Mac keyboard, but it still has that animation and I don't want it. So the easiest way is to just go into the Raycast settings by doing Command, comma, and this will take you to the setting where you can set the keybind. And it's because that I'm using everything on just one window space. This means my switching is going to be instant, as you can see here. I'm not using multiple windows and swiping over them. I'm just using one window and stacking those apps on top of each other. I'm just opening new apps, swapping to Obsidian, going back to Arc, and then coming back to Obsidian. It's much faster and a lot more instant than just using the normal Mac controls or even using the Command tab. There's also this thing called the Quick Links. Let's say I'm in Raycast, I do Command Space, and I type an Arc browser shortcut because I use a Arc browser, you can see here. I can just search through the Arc browser from Raycast. I mean, Alfred can do that too, but you can see how easy it is to do with Raycast. And it's just not the Arc application, it has these other shortcuts associated with other applications such as Notion, I could say. You could do a quick note through that as well. And also, Raycast has its own feature of taking notes. What you can see right here is the toggle floaty notes, where whenever you toggle it, a window will pop up for you, and then you can just type whatever you want or paste whatever you need. Let's say I'm just reviewing some documentation and I want to paste something onto it. I can just toggle that window, paste it, untoggle it, and the information will still be saved. So yeah, if it's ever in the way, you can just hide it and unhide it whenever you want to. Next is the search words and meaning. Spotlight has this as well, but I think Raycast does this better. You might have to do a few more clicks to get into it, but it works, it's pretty accessible, so I don't think that's an issue at all comparing it with Spotlight. You can see some other customizable features that Raycast provides, such as dark mode, light mode, and all that stuff. Now there's this amazing thing that it can also do where when you go Command K, it has these options right here. You can open a file with, or let's say you want to open a file using a different text editor, you could do that. And it also has another feature called the search files, like I'm showing you right now, where you can just set a hotkey or select that command to search any files on your system. This includes files and folders, which means it's even better because this thing is free. And you could search images or search any file type. All you have to do is select that command or access it using a hotkey and just type away. So this just makes Mac file system search so much better. I barely even use Finder anymore. Next, you can see that it also has these other options such as locking your screen, logging out of a user, a clock, and so much more. You could quit applications or access QuickTime Player and all that kind of stuff. There is a lot of commands here that you could do. Calculators, you could even switch your system to dark or light mode here. It makes it so convenient because everything is all in one place. And again, if you aren't already using Raycast, I think you should try it. I'm pretty sure you won't switch back to Spotlight or Alfred because it's just that much better. Thank you guys for watching and hope you have a productive day.